Good morning, students.
Today we are going to continue with the chapter Caring for Public Property. We had started this chapter last day and we had seen that property can be private and public. And you had seen some places of some public properties which are vandalized and why we should not vandalize them or how we should protect them. This is what we had studied last day. Let us continue with the chapter. So today we are going to talk about who maintains public property. We'll be reading from this section. Who maintains public property? So we have seen that public property are properties which are maintained by which are built or maintained by the government, and we all people, all of the citizens, we use it. So the government builds such properties. From where does the government get the money? And even after building that, the maintenance of the property also is cost-worthy. So how does the government get the money to maintain such things? Let us start. Let us read the part. To maintain something means to keep it going and to repair it if something goes wrong. In our country, the government usually builds roads, railways, bridges, railway stations, airports, post offices, and so on. It also maintains them. It builds, runs, and maintains government hospitals and schools. It builds and maintains public libraries and sports centers. It runs and maintains trains and buses. It usually builds power plants to make electricity. It maintains the power plants and the lines that carry electricity from the plants to our homes. So, what does this part say? First and foremost, see, it describes what maintain is. Okay, what it means to maintain. Maintain is when something is kept in good condition, or okay, like for example, I would say, suppose you have a watch. Okay, what do you do is, this watch is your property. What do you do? When you go home, you open it, you keep it in a safe place, you clean your watch. So what do? You maintain your watch, right? So that is maintaining. And if the watch for some reason has some problem, you take it to the shop to repair it. So that is what means to maintain. Okay. So the government, what does it do? It maintains the public properties. In our country, what does the government build? The government builds roads, railways, bridges, railway stations, airports, post offices. Okay, so all these things are public properties. Just the names which I mentioned right now. It also maintains them. It builds these things and also maintains things. It builds, runs, and maintains government hospitals and schools. Also, you have government hospitals and schools. So these are all examples of public property. If you are asked to mention two or three public properties, you can write these names. It builds and maintains public libraries and sports centers. See, the stadium you have in front of your school, the Vivekananda Stadium, that stadium is a public property. It belongs to the government. Okay, it is built by the government and it is meant for the use of the people, and it is maintained by the government. It runs and maintains trains and buses. So trains and buses are also run by the government. It usually builds power plants to make electricity. Like we have the electric supply, that is CSE. So CSE is a power plant. What do? Their electricity is generated, okay, with the use of various kinds of fuels, maybe like coal or petroleum or some kind of fuel. Power is generated, electric power is generated, which is distributed among the people. It maintains the power plants and the lines that carry electricity from the plants to our homes. So you have post lights, right? The posts which you have in front of them, they have wires, and these wires provide electricity to your house. If you have a problem with the electrical wiring inside your house, you call a mechanic who renovates it. But if there is a problem in the main line that is outside on the road, it is the duty of the government to maintain it. Now, let us see, where does the government get this money from? Where does the government get the money for doing all this? It gets money from the people of the country. As you know, the money that people pay the government is called tax. So, people who are working, who earn money, if someone has a business or someone does a job, they pay a part of their salary to the government. And that part of the salary which is being paid to the government is known as tax. For example, when we buy something, a part of the money we pay goes as tax. You go to a shopping mall, you buy a dress, a certain amount of money which you have bought the dress with also goes to the government as tax. The government uses the tax money it gets as tax to build and maintain public property like railways, roads and bridges. So this tax money that the government collects is used to maintain all these public properties. Some roads and bridges are built and maintained with the money collected as toll by the government or a group. Again, also some other form of money is collected as toll. Okay, toll tax. What is toll tax? You see in this picture. See this picture. In this picture, you have a bridge where cars are going and there are barricades here. So, these barricades here, there are people inside who take money from these cars. Why? Because they are crossing this bridge. There are certain bridges and roads where you have to pay the toll tax to cross from one side to another. So this toll money is also used by the government to look after the public properties. Now, I hope this is clear. Okay, so what did we see here? That the government maintains public properties and the government uses the tax and toll money to maintain these things. This is all that is in this part. Now, let's move on to the next part. In the next part, we have common property. So, this is the third kind of property we are seeing. First, we have seen private property. Next, we have seen public property. And now, we are looking at common property. What are common property? Some things belong to people. Some things belong to many people but are not public property. So, in general, we have studied that things which belong to many people are known as public property, right? But there are still some things which might belong to many people but they are not public property. For example, the lawns, corridors, lifts and parking lots of a block of flats belong to all the people living in the flats. We can call them common property of these people. It is their common duty to look after these things because if they get spoiled, all the people will suffer. In the same way, the swimming pool and sports gear of a club belongs to all its members. If one member dirties or damages them, all of them suffer. So, you see what is being said here. Common property, what are common property? Think of a place, okay, maybe a society, housing society. There is a swimming pool in the, see this picture, okay. In a housing society, there is a swimming pool. Does only one person come to the swimming pool? No. All the members living in that flat, all the members living in that part, come to this swimming pool and they use it. So, this kind of property is a common property. For example, a parking lot. In a building, there is a place where the cars are parked. Does one person park a car there? No. All the people who own cars in that building park their cars in that parking lot. So, this parking lot is a common property. It belongs to all those people who have cars living in that particular flat. Now, if someone throws garbage on that parking lot, will it harm only one person or will it harm all the people living there? All the people living there will be affected because if I go and throw garbage in that parking lot, somebody else might want to park their car there. But because I have thrown garbage there, they can't park their car there. So, I am doing something which is bad and it is harming someone else. Similarly, if I also want to go and park my car there, if there is no other space, then I cannot also park there because I have thrown garbage there. So, this is why common property is to be maintained by all. Whoever lives, it is all of their duty to maintain it. A school is not owned by the students, so it is not really common property. But the classrooms, corridors, playgrounds and so on are meant for the use of all students. In that sense, they are common property. If one student spoils something, all the others will suffer. So every student should feel proud of looking after school property. So you see, schools can either be government owned, that means they are public property, or they can be privately owned, that means they are private property. So it is not common property, but we all go and use our schools, right? We go to our classrooms, we sit there, we go from one room to another with the help of the corridors, we go to the playground to play. So if we do not look after these places, it will affect each and every one of us. Suppose you are sitting in class 4A or 4B today. You dirty the room. You make it, you break the tables and chairs. Tomorrow again, when you come to your class, you will be the one who is going to suffer because you are going to sit there. You will need benches to sit. So it is going to harm you. Similarly, if the broken benches are left there, the next class 3, when they are going to come to class 4, they are also going to suffer because they have to sit in broken benches. So similarly, schools, although they are not common property, they are maintained by all of us together. So, this is the end of the chapter. It's a very easy chapter, as I have said earlier also. Read the chapter. If you have any doubts, obviously ask me. So, that's all for today. Thank you and bye-bye.